John Jones.
Okay, you're going with John Jones. I can tell you the diary people would most like to read is Aisling's. Oh. Aisling there, of course. So at the end of that round, it's 1 point for Sean's team and 4 points for Jason's team. Join us after the break where we'll be finding out the thing you'll most miss about Big Brother. Welcome back to the 8 out of 10 Cats Big Brother special. And the winner is the name of our final round. Here's your first one. Top thing people will miss about Big Brother.
I'm going to miss Marcus Bentley, voiceover man.
He's knackered, isn't he? What's he going to do?
A Geordie that's had a job for 10 years?
Yeah.
He's like their king.
Yeah.
I think he'll end up doing, like, check out number four, please. He'll just do all them. What unexpected item in the bagging area, man.
Sorry, it'll be. It's going to be great.
Sir.
I'm going to miss those close-ups of inanimate objects you get every so often when Marcus Bentley goes, 9 p.m. and it just shows a bit of a fork or something. or a flower pot with a bit of dew dropping off it. I would watch a movie of that. If they cut all those bits together, I would watch that for 48 hours non-stop.
Do you know what I'm going to miss? Turning my house upside down looking for the fucking remote. Because I used to find stuff. I'd find keys, money, bits and bobs that I thought I'd lost forever. I'd go, where's the fucking remote?
Oh, God, I haven't seen a freezer.
Well, they missed Davina.
That's the right answer.
Yeah, that's nice.
I could forget that, really.
Oh, yeah, OK. Yes, the top thing people will miss about Big Brother is Davina McCall.
Yeah.
Oh. Oh. Hey! Oh, I love Davina.
Top thing viewers would like to see replace Big Brother.
I'd like to see Come Dine With Me, Cannibal Special.
Well, it'd be quite good if they had to cut bits off themselves and serve it to the guests. So it would be, there would be a gamble as to how much you were prepared to slice off your own body and fry.
To win that grand.
Yeah.
I'd like to see a fat person chasing a pig through the Alps. And it's real fast, little pigs. And they go, you've got to catch that pig. You've got 24 hours and we're going to shoot you. And they have to run through the Alps. It's really uphill. Like, the little pig's going, off it goes.
What they need is just something that is going to cheer people up. So just on a continuous loop, that chimpanzee ripping that woman's face off. It's not another reality show, is it?
No, it's not. I mean, it's just...
More drama or more...
I will tell you the answer. The answer is more films.
Yeah. More films.
More films.
Fair enough.
The top five also included more game shows and more news. But weirdly, no one suggested going outside or reading a book. OK, one more question. Final question, everyone. Eyes down. Best ever housemate.
Oh.
Come on.
Sean, let's put him in. Let's put him in for the last day. It'll be brilliant, man. I think he'll be amazing in there.
In Ultimate give
him,
Big Brother?
Give him a pen knife and just see what he does with it.
I think if you went in there for 24 hours, I imagine people would go, yeah, the thing about Fritzer was he seemed like a kind man.
I would like to go in the Big Brother house, but driving a very, very heavy piece of machinery.
Best ever housemate, Jason, what do you reckon? Who's your favourite been?
Me? Nadia.
Nadia was amazing in that.
I think she looks all right as a woman. Everyone takes the piss, and I think, actually, I think she looks all right. There's a bloke near us who walks around walking his dog in a dress. He's got a beard. And I go, it's like from the Kenny Everett.
The thing about Nadia as well is when she came out, she was just so... When she won it, she sort of felt... It was such a sort of affirmation.
It was a big moment for, you know, a group of people who had spent a lot of time, you know, hiding, keeping quiet about who they truly are. And then when she won and came out, they finally could, you know, be proud of who they were. Portuguese.
Actually, I tell you who my favourite is. Brian Dowling. Yeah. I like Brian Dowling.
He's good.
Brian, best ever housemate. Who do you think the best ever housemate?
Brian.
Brian. There. Here, we've seen the man.
Charlie, just final thing for you. Charlie, favourite ever Big Brother housemate?
Science, probably was, actually. So I liked Science just because he went in there with the sole purpose of really annoying everyone else. It was kind of like watching Sean go in with a penknife or something.
It was like that. I remember when Mackosy first went in, you were given that challenge, weren't you, when you first went into the house, to be as annoying as possible.
I was.
And due to an admin error, no one ever told you to stop. Favourite ever Big Brother housemate? Go on, best ever housemate.
It's probably going to be Nikki.
It's the right answer. Yes, the best ever housemate is Nikki Graham. I'd just like to say best ever housemate was an extremely close wrong thing, and if you're watching this at home, Shabnam, you'll be pleased to know you came a very respectable 187th. Well, that sound tells me it's the end of the round and the end of the show, which means the final scores are Sean, Brian and Jared have 3 points, Jason, Josie and Charlie have one, they've got 4 points. Thanks to all our panellists, our wonderful studio audience and to all of you for watching at home. That's it from us. We'll be back with a regular 8 out of 10 cats next week. So, Big Brother has finally come to an end, and as a fitting tribute, I'd like to be the very last person in the history of broadcasting to say this word on television. Kamal. Good night.
Yes, it really is the beginning of the end. Ultimate Big Brother, the final from 7:30, and that's tomorrow. Now, coming up next on 4, comedian Rufus Hound recalls his funniest year, 2000.